Sri Kalyan Banerjee.
Honourable Deputy Speaker, sir, today we are discussing the Negotiable Instruments Amendment Bill 2017. The threshold, I say that some beneficial provisions have been made. This is in addition to. No doubt it's a good endeavor. But the question is somewhere else. Question is that whether the cases in relation to the Negotiable Instruments Amendments Bill 2017, a negotiable main act, when the complaint is lodged, whether the trial is being taken place or not. And most of the cases, years after years, times are being taken. Now there are deficiencies in the Negotiable Instrument Act, Parent Act is concerned, 88. The entire object is that when the check is dishonored or bounced, the victim must get the justice as quickly as possible. In fact, to get the justice by victim in every criminal case is a facet of an Article 21 of the Constitution of India. Now, incidentally and unfortunately, the cases in relation to the Negotiable Instruments Act, Negotiable Instrument Act, where the checks are bounced, are not being taken up seriously even by the courts. These types of bounce, the sufferer are mostly middle class, lower middle class peoples are suffering and poor peoples are suffering. In a small commercial transactions, I am not talking about the rich people, they are most suffer. There is no time stipulation, although you are saying about that is a summary trial. But there is no time stipulation, has been stipulated in the Act itself, as regards within how many days the trial has to be completed. But when the matter comes to the courts, in the first court, it takes up not so much seriously. Now you see, you have seen the 135, the amendment which has been sought for. That A, 143(1)(a), in a summary trial or summon case where he pleads not guilty to the accusation made in the complaint. Until the summons are served, they will not come. Now, in these types of cases, the maximum persons really they are master of committing frauds. That it is difficult to serve summons even against them. I appreciate our endeavor, but in reality, it is difficult. I know that the systems of the courts are not within your jurisdiction. But since you are also part of a ministry of the government itself, in that case, the court should be more serious in dealing with the Negotiable Instruments Act. Facts and figures are being given to you. 20%, almost 20% cases in relation to the NI Act are pending before the courts. Now the question is the fast track court. It is often being said, sir, fast track courts. What is a fast track court? Fast track court doesn't mean, is it mean that the person who is handling a normal cases, he would be given the fast track court jurisdiction. The moment you will be speaking about the fast track court, you must create the post for that court. Otherwise, it is futile to talk about any fast track court itself. The trials are going on and going on, and it is not unknown that the under prisoners are languishing in the jail years after years. Therefore, neither the victim is getting the justice, nor the accused is getting the justice at all. Nobody is getting the justice because of the pendency of the cases. And it is also correct that the criminal courts of our country are overburdened. This is really, criminal courts are overburdened. I will request you to consider, I am not telling that immediately we have to do. In this NI Act, complaint has to be lodged to the appropriate criminal court within certain times, 15 days times, after the letters have been sent. I will request you to consider in future for the affected persons that instead of lodging complaint, along with the lodging complaint, I make a provision to lodge a complaint with the concerned police station also. If it is done in the police station, then when the notice would be served by the police, then the immediate steps are taken. Because the police is the appropriate persons who can catch hold of the accused. But when summons are being served to the court, these persons, those who are committing these types of crime, of this dishonoring the checks, they know the style how to avoid service of summons. Therefore, in future, kindly consider that part, that aspect also. Everybody is really concerned now today in India that justice is really delayed. And justice is, if justice is delayed, then justice is denied.
4 o'clock we have to pass this one.
Courts, then we start. If you look into the Supreme Court even today, today's position, 7 or 8 vacancies are there pending. High court vacancies are there, more than the 400. Exact figure I can't say. Therefore, the criminal trials, similarly in the lower judicial. Now, I am fully supporting these things, there's no problem. But since I have got the chance that you are here, think about how to do it, how to make it more speedily justice is being delivered in this case. And see, until the person concerned appears before the criminal court, the getting of 20% compensation, question of receiving the benefit doesn't arise at all. Now, kindly see, come to your clause C of the bill. There, when the appeal would be preferred, appeal would be preferred, then in that case, the person concerned has to deposit, the appellate, to deposit such sum which shall be minimum of 20%. Right? Of the fine or compensation awarded by the trial court, only 20%. Is this amount is sufficient? Because it leaves to the discretion. Now in the criminal court, trial court, first is one has to suffer for 4 years or 5 years. Then after 5 years in the appeal court what? 20% have to be deposited. Why not 100% should be deposited? Why not 50% should be deposited? Think about that, please. And kindly see, here the deposition would be made, that is not compulsorily would be given to the victim. Because your clause says, clause C, subclause 3, the appellate court may direct the release of the amount deposited by the appellant. May direct means it's not a mandatory. It remains with the discretion of the appellate court. Now when cheque has been given, admittedly, some due was there, that's the reason cheque has been given. If that's so, why at this stage of appeal, if the appellate court, why when appeal will be filed, why 100% will not be deposited, and why appellate court will not be given the, why minimum 20%, 100%? Because if the, in the trial court, when the trial will take place, one has to say he has put the signature in the check itself or not. Question is why the check has been paid, question is why the check has not been paid, reasonableness of issuance of the check, that would not be subject matter of the court itself. Whether the check is or not, that's the question. Therefore the signature is the only the question. If that's so, when you are thinking, love, kindly think about this also. Why the nearly 100% amount will not be deposited in the appellate court? And appellate, at the time of admission of the appeal, or before granting bail, condition should be imposed that amount should be given to the victim person is concerned. So just 2 minutes. Just 1-2 minutes. Therefore, I will request you to consider these aspects of the matter, because my experience speaks that the only the middle class people is mostly suffering in this matters, or the poor people are suffering. In future, kindly think about that. With this, I conclude. Endeavor is good, but more endeavors are to take. You are thinking about the victims.
Dr. Prakash.
Therefore, please think about that.